Today we're going to be talking about AC/DC 2018 and comparing it to Lightroom. If you're like me, you've been paying for Lightroom for years and you've seen some upgrades, but you're probably annoyed with paying Adobe $10 a month that you're locked into it when they're not upgrading as much as they should and there's still some performance issues, not to mention the colors aren't always the best. So I've been looking at competing software. I like Capture One Pro, but it has some issues, specifically with its library. Recently, I tested out On One Photo Raw, which also has some nice potential, but it's lacking in quite a few areas. So today, we're going to mainly compare AC/DC to Lightroom. I am going to use Photo Mechanic as a comparison as well, just because we're going to talk about culling photos, and just kind of see how AC/DC stacks up. So there's going to be five main areas we're going to look at. Number one, we're going to look at importing photos into the application. Number two, we're talking about culling the photos, which is just how you sort through them and tag and delete the ones that you don't want. Three, we're going to look at organizing as a whole and navigating through the library. Four, we're going to look at what it is to find a particular file, how you do that. And then fifth, the development. And we'll just kind of see how it stacks up compared to Lightroom. First, let's go ahead and talk about importing. Importing isn't that big of a deal with AC/DC. It's actually very easy to import. Unlike some of the other software out there, specifically On One Photo Raw, which if you look at my previous entries, you can see that I reviewed that. On One Photo Raw doesn't have an import button. AC/DC does. And you can import from a variety of sources. You can import from your disk. You can point to a specific folder. When you're importing, you can name the files and put it to whatever directory you want. It's every bit as good as Lightroom's. I don't have any issues with the import feature. But let's move on to culling photos, and here's where I have some issues. Now, for years, I've been using Photo Mechanic, and it's, in my opinion, one of the best pieces of software out there, just because in Photo Mechanic, you can group your RAWs and JPEGs together. So here's the exact same folder as in AC/DC. So in AC/DC, you can see how the RAWs and JPEGs are separated. Now, it's just an awful lot to go through, but let's say you decided that, here's a stupid photo of me, let's say you want to get rid of this one. In Photo Mechanic, you can delete this and it'll delete both files simultaneously. In AC/DC, how you do it is you have to find both photos. There's no option to lump them together. Lightroom also has the same problem. So in this regard, AC/DC, in my opinion, cannot replace Photo Mechanic, nor can Lightroom, which is unfortunate. Now you can separate the two. You can sort by file type. And you can have all the JPEGs up here and all the RAWs down here. But I haven't found a way to group them together. So that's one issue or one area that I think AC/DC could improve upon. But as far as browsing speed, it's really one of the best out there. Lightroom, there's a delay. In AC/DC, you can go back and forth between images. And it does a fantastic job. In case you're wondering about these photos, these were taken at the MoPop, Museum of Pop of Modern Art type of stuff, or popular art over at in Seattle. They had a Star Trek exhibit and a bunch of other stuff. So pretty neat, nerdy stuff. But okay, there's that. Moving on. So we've talked about importing. We've talked about culling your photos. Importing, I'd give AC/DC a pass on. Culling, I would give it average, with Photo Mechanic being better. As far as organizing, AC/DC does some really cool stuff that I like. So one thing I really like about AC/DC is it has this calendar feature where you can point to a specific date and see the photos from that particular date. Now, before I was browsing in the folder view, now we're looking at the calendar view. Now, one thing that's interesting, what we're looking at here, these TIFF files, these actually don't exist anymore. This was here earlier today. I deleted them in Lightroom. So it's telling me here that they're no longer part of it. And that's why I want to remove that item. Now, you can eventually update the catalog and have those removed. But for this illustration or for this video, I haven't done that yet. But it is really neat to be able to go to any particular day and see just see the photos. Now, you can do that in Lightroom, but it's not as easy. Now, here again, you see, here's a photo that had been removed. I am finding issues with the cataloging system in AC/DC. It doesn't work perfectly. It works okay. You do need to do a lot more maintenance with it, whereas Lightroom, I think it's better. So can it replace the Lightroom catalog? If you use AC/DC to do all your manipulation, yes. But if you're using multiple apps, no, I would say it does interfere with it. It's okay. I do like Lightroom's catalog better. Now, this calendar feature is really neat, but let me go over to Lightroom for a minute and show you how you can get there just as easily. So in Lightroom, it's a lot faster and easier to sort by a specific calendar date. Now, we're looking at a library here of 59,000 photos, years and years and years worth of photos. And if I want to go to last Sunday, I can pull it up very easy. Here's all the photos. Here's where they are. So it's a little bit different than the calendar system. I actually do like the calendar icon a lot easier. So I'd give AC/DC the edge here. But let's say you want to find a photo from a particular camera or a particular date other than that way. It's okay. I actually like the way it does it. So let's say you want to find a camera. Now here's where it gets a little confusing because it's not quite as intuitive or as linear as Lightroom, but you can go down by camera model, pick the camera model you want, and then you can pick a date you want. So let's just say I want all the photos from the 5D Mark IV on a particular date. And what you can see here is you're having to scroll through a lot of stuff to find exactly, well, where is the date? Let's say I want one from, I don't know. Let's say a few months ago when I did a karate thing. So you can see here I'm struggling to find it. Eventually you can sort through this stuff. You can find it. So I'm still trying to find the created by date. Now I've been using this application for a couple weeks now, and I'm still having issues trying to find the exact date. So you can see here it's still not in any of these commonly used categories. Maybe in the... Nope, not in the IPTC. So at this point, I'm a little frustrated. I can't find a particular date. Now, it's probably in there. It probably gives you that option, but I'm not finding it easily. If I go over to Lightroom just to kind of compare, so let's just say, again, we want all the photos. I'm going to sort by 5D Mark IV. And then if I want a particular date, you can change any of these fields to any particular time. And then you can see, oh, here's the photos from November. And I can see, oh, on the 4th of November, oh, look, there's a karate tournament I was looking for. And if I want to see the files from that day, specifically the JPEGs, very easily. And then you can move it around. Now, granted, I've used Lightroom a lot longer, but I think you see that's already way more intuitive than AC/DC is. So even though AC/DC can narrow it down, it's a lot more frustrating. The other thing I found very frustrating with AC/DC when it comes to organizing, let's say you're trying to find a particular video file. So let me go back to the calendar. I'm going to reset this here. Which you can see, I'm trying to figure out how to do that. Well, you can see from my struggle there, I still don't know how to get back to the catalog of all the images. Again, so what we're trying to do is just get back to all the photos. I haven't quite figured out how to do that in the catalog of AC/DC. Now, I can go by photo calendar. So there's options, but again, it's not as easy as in Lightroom. Okay, so now let's say I'm trying to find a video file. I'm going to go back to all files. Doesn't really matter what camera I have here, but I can go and say, okay, here's video files, and I can sort through it and find them very easily. Now, in my photo library or in Lightroom, I've got videos from multiple cameras over different years, different file formats, everything from 3GP files to M2TS to MTS to MOVs, MPEGs, and MP4s. But I can just say search for a video file. In AC/DC, that's not an option. You can't search for everything. What you can do is search for a particular type of file in the entire catalog. So let's just say I'm searching for an MP4 file. You have to do it the old school way. And this is where it gets unintuitive completely. I couldn't figure out that I had to click this triangle to click off images only. Then you can do a search. You can search through the entire database, and oh look, there's your MP4 files. But what about your MOV files? Well, if you can't remember which is which, here's how I had to set it up. I had to make a separate search for MTS files, and a separate one for MPEG files, and a separate one for MP4s and MOVs. This was a painstaking process, and it really should be something that's easier that AC does natively, and it doesn't. Yeah, you can find this stuff. Yeah, it does work. Again, I would give the edge here to Lightroom for organizing, but AC/DC is passable in that regard. So now we can move on to the development module and which does a better job. So let's go back to the most recent day out, which was last week. It was Monday. It was Martin Luther King Day. So I'm going to go to the calendar, find those files. Wait for the computer to catch up. Okay. Let's just take a particular photo for editing. This is my friend George. He needed some headshots for his LinkedIn profile. So I shot these with a Sony a6500 and I used a Leica 75mm f2 APO lens with an adapter on it. So this is the raw file straight out of the camera as it looks in AC/DC. We'll go through the develop module. And then we'll go over to the develop module for the same photo in Lightroom. All right, I'm actually going to create another one here. We'll start from scratch. Okay, here's a scratch on both. We'll put Lightroom over here on the left, and I'll put AC/DC on the right. So out of the gate, which one looks better? I would give the edge a little bit to Lightroom, just as a starting place. There's some pretty high contrast shadows over here on my friend on the right, but that's okay. Let's just kind of see what we can do with the images. One of the main things I do with photos is I like to adjust the highlights and shadows just because, yes, ideally I should have better lighting, but it's not always possible. So let's just deal with the highlights. We'll lower that up and we'll do the fill light. You can see when I use the fill light, it's bringing up the highlights again, which is kind of annoying. So let's just compensate a little bit. And so what I found is it's very hard to get good highlight recovery. Now there is an option here called Light Equalizer where you can do a little bit more, but then the colors start to get a little unnatural in my opinion. And you can see how it kind of works. It works okay. Now the performance, it seems a little laggy to me. So you can see when I make adjustment, it takes just a split second. It's not bad, but I am running on an 8700K interprocessor, which as of right now is the fastest processor for consumers on the market. And I'm also running a 1080 Ti with 64 gigs of RAM. I would expect this to be very snappy, and it's just a slight delay with AC/DC. It's not bad, but it is there. If I compare that to Lightroom, the sliders are a lot more responsive, which is kind of funny because most people don't have nice things to say about Lightroom and their sliders, but this actually works quite well. And what you're seeing here is, to me, the highlight recovery seems to be a lot greater, and when I bump the shadows, it tends to do a better job of preserving that data than AC/DC does. Now, this may be personal preference, but I really do think that the algorithms and the responsiveness of the sliders to what you see happening with Lightroom is better. Now, with just a few tweaks, here is Lightroom. Here's AC/DC. This looks more neon to me, whereas this seems a little more natural. Now, if I wanted to bump this up even more, just do a slight few tweaks here, I would still give the edge to Lightroom in terms of realism versus this. No, that might not be bad, but as a starting place, before I do any further edits, that seems a bit harsh, whereas this seems a little more natural to me. Again, personal preference, but I think what you're going to find is that the more you go into images and the more you try to edit them, Lightroom's going to do a better job, retain more detail, and quasi, Lightroom's not my favorite. I prefer Capture One's rendering, but again, we're compared to Lightroom. Capture One cannot compete with ACDC or Lightroom in terms of organizing or as a library, which is why we're not including it here. And then, of course, Lightroom has some other benefits where it has the ability to use the camera profiles and give you kind of a different starting place. Better, worse, whatever, but it does give you that option, whereas ACDC doesn't give you that option. Yeah, for me, I would probably start with that as an image for further editing, not that. Again, personal preference, but I think you're going to find that ACDC cannot compete with Lightroom for editing. I wouldn't even rate it as okay. I mean, it has some other features here. You can click on the edit button, and then you can do layers and things like that. And, okay, there's some options here, but I've played with these, and they're not any better than the options already in Lightroom. The other thing with Lightroom, you get Photoshop, which is a much better program. Now, the difference in cost, ACDC Ultimate is about $100 a year, once, and that's it, versus $10 a month or $120 a year. Chances are you'd probably want to upgrade to the newest ACDC next year anyway, or have the newest Lightroom. We'll talk more about value here in a moment. Okay, so let's go to the conclusion. Let's figure out which is the best way to go. Is it better to go with Lightroom or ACDC? And so let's just review each of the topics that we talked about before. The first topic we talked about was importing. I would give both of them just fine. You can import images very easily, have them go wherever you want to, break them down by folder and by date, fine. Culling, that's the second thing we talked about. Neither one is a good option. For that, I would still give the nod to Photo Mechanic. Really, there's nothing else like it. And I've never really done a review of Photo Mechanic, but it's easily the most valuable piece of software I've ever purchased because they keep giving you free updates and free updates. And I haven't paid for an upgrade to that software in years. I keep waiting for version 6, but they've been on version 5.x for the duration, and they keep making it better. So let's go over to organizing. When it comes to organizing, ACDC is okay. It's not as good as Lightroom, in my opinion. It's okay. I do like the calendar feature. The library, it's okay. Again, Lightroom I find more efficient. When you have to find a particular file, ACDC is a mess. It just is. Try to find a video. They really need to improve that. Trying to find a particular photo from a particular date, from a particular camera, you can do it. It involves going to searching and different menus and things like that, but it's not intuitive, and it's not fast, and it's not easy. So again, I'd give the edge to Lightroom. Developing, ACDC's, I'm not even going to say it's okay. I'm just not pleased with it. I would use any other software before ACDC. Lightroom for sure, Capture One for sure, Irradiant on the Mac or other developers, I think, do a better job. So in conclusion, is ACDC 2018 Ultimate worth the price? Is it worth your money? Is it worth switching from Lightroom? Depends on how much you hate Adobe. It also depends on what your budget is. If you want to just pay for some software, be done, and it's good enough, and you're not going to do a lot of editing, or any editing at all, you just want to place the store images, have a catalog, and you might be happy with that. For me, it's worth the $10 a month to pay for Lightroom. After this review, I'm actually going to go ahead and uninstall ACDC from my computer. Now, I want to say thank you to the developers. They were very nice for letting me have a copy to review this, but I'm going to pay $10 a month and stick with Lightroom, which pains me to say because I really want to go away from Adobe just after viewing this. And I've also looked at some other software out there like On One Photo Raw. I've tried Capture One 11. And even though Capture One 11 does a better job editing, Lightroom, from an organizational and digital asset management standpoint, is still the best on the market. So unfortunately, I'm not going to recommend ACDC at this time. Hopefully, if they do some more developments, such as RAW and JPEG grouped together, that would be helpful. The ability to find video files, that would be helpful. They need to improve performance on developing a little bit. And then I think they're heading the right direction. I'd like to see them be very successful, but right now I would still say Lightroom's the best. Okay, thanks for watching.